बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सोशल ग्रुप्स एंड इट्स टाइप्स। इट्स सब्जेक्ट इज स्कूल कम्युनिटी एंड टीचर। इट्स लेक्चर नंबर 8 एंड कोड ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट इज EDU 272। द आउटलाइंस ऑफ दिस लेक्चर्स आर सोशल ग्रुप, function of social group, essential of social group and types of social group. So we will study about these outlines of the lectures. Here, what is a social group? A social group is a collection of people who interact with each other and share similar characteristics and sense of unity. A social category is a collection of people who do not interact but who share similar characteristics. And if we take examples of groups, so these include families, companies, circle of friends, clubs, local chapters of fraternities and sororities, and local religious congregations. Renowned social psychologist Muzaffar Sharif formulated a technical definition of a social group. So we can also define it that when two or more persons are in a state of interaction, it can be called simply as group. Or in other words, we can say that a number of persons with the same goals, expectations, values who interact with each other is called a social group. Now, here some other definitions of social groups are there. Like E.S. Bogardus said, a number of units of anything in close proximity to one another. Ogburn and Nemcoff, they said that whenever two or more individuals come together and influence one another, that is called a social group. Arnold Green said that an aggregate of individuals which is organized and having common interest and activities. So these are the other definitions of social group. Now here some functions are social groups. So what are the functions? Social groups are defined and separated by boundaries. Leadership is the ability to organize a group of people to achieve a common purpose. So decision making is the mental processes resulting in the selection of course of action among several alternative scenarios. So there are different functions. Like the first one is defining boundaries. Defining boundaries means to identify who are the members of the group. So one important factor in how symbolic boundaries function is how widely they are accepted as valid. Symbolic boundaries are necessary but insufficient. So condition for social change. According to sociologist, it is only when symbolic boundaries are widely agreed upon can they take on a constraining character and become social boundaries. Thus, rituals and traditions to define boundaries are extremely influential in determining how group interact. The other function is choosing leaders. What does it mean? By nature, groups resolve the issue of leadership. So a leader is who? A leader is the one who occupies central role or position of the dominance and influence. So the trait theory of leadership seeks to find attributes that all leaders possess. So according to the researchers of leadership, all individuals can and do emerge as leader across a variety of situations and tasks. Significant relationships exist between leadership and such individual traits as intelligence, adjustment, extroversion, consciousness, openness to experience and general self-efficacy. So there are different styles of leadership. Like leadership styles refers to the leader's behavior. So it is the result of the philosophy, personality, and experience of the leader. Under the autocratic leadership style, all decision-making powers are centralized in the leader, as with dictators. So the democratic leadership style consists of the leader sharing the decision-making abilities with group members by promoting the interest of the group members and by practicing social equality. So this style of leadership works well because people feel their voice is being heard, but it can result in fighting and animosity if opinions clash and decisions cannot be reached. So in the laissez-faire leadership style, a person may be a leadership position without providing leadership, so leaving the group to fend for itself. So subordinates are given a free hand in deciding their own policies and methods. So the other function is making decisions. It means that a combined aggregate of all the ideas, opinions, and thoughts of members of the group ever in. So decision making is the mental processes basically that resulting in a selection of course of action among several alternatives scenarios. So decision making is a mental process resulting in the selection of the course of action among several alternatives scenarios. Every decision making process produces a final choice. So group decision making is the process used when individuals are brought together in a group to solve problems. So according to the idea of synergy, decisions made collectively tend to be more effective than decisions made by a single individual. So however, there are situations in which the decisions made by the collection of individuals so are riddled with error or poor judgment. For example, groups high in cohesion have been noted to have a negative effect on the group decision making and hence on group effectiveness. So there are some formal system of making decisions, like consensus decision making tries to avoid winners and losers. Consensus requires that a majority approve a given course of action, but that the minority agrees to go along with the course of action. So in other words, if the minority opposes the course of action, so consensus requires that the course of action be modified to remove objectionable features. So when the consensus is impossible, impractical, or undesirable, so different voting system can be used for group to decide on an outcome. So three examples are range voting, majority voting, and plurality voting. So range voting lets each member scores one or more of the available options. So the options with the highest average is chosen. So majority voting requires support from one more than 50% of the members of the group. So plurality voting is where the largest block in a group decides, even it falls short of the majorities. So setting goals. How we set goals? The common ambition of group for which they strive to perform and achieve. So setting goals, basically what? Setting goal involves establishing specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-targeted goals. And we call it SMART. SMART means specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-targeted. So setting goals affect outcomes in four ways: by approving choice, effort, persistence, and cognition. So by choice, we mean that goal narrow attentions and direct efforts to goal relevant activities and away from perceived undesirable and goal irrelevant actions. Secondly, goals can lead to more effort. For examples, if a person typically produces 4 widgets an ore and sets the goals of producing six. He may work more intensely toward the goal. Third, through improved persistence, someone becomes more prone to work together. Setbacks when pursuing a goal, finally, by cognition, we mean that goals can lead individuals to develop and change their behavior. Assigning tasks, it means that each member of the group is assigned a task which he cares and look after and is responsible for that. Then controlling member behavior. It means that behavior of the members are continually controlled because deviant behavior of the members may be dangerous and harmful and rather fatal to the group. So the group popularization is the phenomena that when placed in group situations, people will make decisions and form opinions that are more extreme than when they are in individual situations. The phenomena has shown that after participating in a discussion group, members tend to advocate more extreme positions and call for riskier courses of actions than individuals who did not participate in any such discussion. So the importance of group popularization is significant as it helps explain group behavior in the variety of real life situations. So example of these situations include public policy, terrorism, college life, and violence. For instance, group popularization can largely be seen at political conventions that are broadcasted nationwide before a large election. Generally, a political party holds the same ideals and fundamentals. So at times, however, individual members of the party may waver on where they stand on smaller subjects. So during a political convention, the political party as a group is strongly united in one location and is exposed to many persuasive speakers. So as a result, each individual in the political party leaves more energized and steadfast on where the party as the whole stands with regards to all subjects and behind all candidates, even if they were wavering on where they stood beforehand. Now there are some more essentials for the group, like collection of the people. This is very important for a social group. Then communication between the people. If you have a group and if there is no communication between the people, then it means there is no such social system. Like dependency among members. If you have a social group, you must depend upon one another. If there is no dependency, then there is no social group. Common identity. There should be a common identity among the social group. Like they should have at least one characteristic among unique in all social group. Common feeling of unity. This should be the feeling in a social group that there should be a unity. There should be a common feeling among the people of social group. So common certain goals. That social group must have a common goals. Then share norms and traditions. They must share what they have, the norms and traditions. Now, what are the types of social group? So groups can be classified on several bases, like we can define or we can categorize social group as per size, structure, contact, relations, and identifications. So we can see that social group is can be categorized on the basis of size, structure, contact, relationship, and identification. So first of all, we see that type of the group on the basis of size. So on the basis of size, social groups are classified by the German sociologist George Simmel. Dyad means contains two persons in a group, establishes one relationship. Then triad. Triad means contains three persons in a group, establishes three relations. Tetrad. It means contains four persons, establishes six relations. Then pentod contains five persons, establishes 10 relations. See here that if we have dyad, so it means there are two persons, A and B, and in triad we have three persons, A, B and C, and then a group of four and group of five is there. Social group on the basis of structure and organization. So on the basis of structure and organization, social groups are classified by dyad syndesmes. Like formal group. Formal group always possess some rules and regulations. They have some schedules, they have some roles. Then there are some voluntary formal groups, coercive formal groups, utilitarian formal groups. Then the other form is informal group. Informal group also have no rules and regulations. They are free to do anything, whatever they like. So first of all, we see that voluntary formal groups. What type of group is this? In this group, the people join of their own volition. So persons join the group by its own choice. And the people who are in voluntary formal groups, they are free to join or withdrawn from the group at any time. So example, it's a company, job organization, that in any private job, you can join willingly and then you can leave that job without any consent. Then coercive formal group. This group is also called as a delegate group. Persons join as a representative of number of people. Join the group of their own benefits or societal benefits. Like in a village, we make a committees and we participate in that committee willingly. So that type of committees or meetings or groups, these are called coercive formal group. So persons either elected or nominated by some power. So example is the parliament. Example. Utilitarian formal groups. This group is also called as a involuntary group. That type of group doesn't depend upon the person's choice. This group not forced to join the particular organization but feel compelled to join the group. So people join it to achieve their own goals. Example is one's family, race, caste. Then we discuss informal group. Informal group basically provide different but important things. Provide relaxation and reduce stress. It involves in fun activities. It helps keep people good social health and welfare. So its example is the group of friends, families, passengers, sharing bus, etc. Then type of the group on the basis of contact, social ties. Like this is classified by C.H. Coley. It is classified into two main groups, primary and secondary. So what are the primary group? The concept of primary group was introduced by Charles Horton Cooley in his book Social Organization, published in 1909. Through Cooley has never used the term secondary group, but while discussing the groups other than those of primary, some sociologists like Kate Davis, Ogburn and McLeaver have popularized other groups such as secondary groups. So hence the classification of primary and secondary groups is made on the basis of the nature of social contact and degree of intimacy, size and the degree of organization, etc. So the primary group is the most simple and universal form of the association. So it is a nucleus of all social organization. It is a small group in which a small number of persons come into direct contact with another. They meet face to face for mutual help, companionships and discussion of common questions. They live in the presence and thought of one another, and the primary group is a small group in which a member lives together. In a primary group, they have strong emotional attachments, they have small size and informal, they have stability, they have similarity of backgrounds, they are limited of self-interest, They have personal relationships. They are continuity of relationships. They persist over extensive period of time. They face-to-face interactions, and they always have a feeling of we. An example is family, basketball. In secondary groups, these are such type of groups are like formal and impersonal relations. They are usually large in size, and options of membership is there in secondary group. Less intimate and less sentimental group is there. I feeling, this is I, what I, this is called in secondary group. An example like political parties. So now types on the basis of relations. So classified by Jord Hessen into unsocial group, pseudo social group, antisocial groups, and pro-social groups. First of all, unsocial group. Unsocial group means this type of group live to themselves and for themselves. They don't participate in larger society of which they are a part. They don't mix up with the other people and remains alone. Example of murderers, thieves, etc. So these people always remain. Then pseudo-social group. Participate in a larger society and they participate only for interest and gain. They don't care for the greater good of the society. So example are politicians and feudals. Antisocial groups. Antisocial groups are like they are act against interest of the interest of the society. They destroy public peace and prosperity, property, and its examples are calling a strike by labor union, plans of political parties to overthrow. Pro-social group is there. This is antonym of the anti-social group. They work for the interest of the larger society of which they are a part. Engaged in constructive activities and increasing welfare of the society. And its examples are like volunteers. And if we see in Pakistani scenarios also, so like Tiger group is there. So types on the basis of identifications, like classified, it is classified by Summer into in-group, out-group, reference. So in-group means that they have strong identifications and loyalty with members of their own group. The group by which an individual identifies oneself and they embody its feeling. Examples are family, tribe, sex, college, occupations. And out-group means they always contact between they and we. The group to which the people feel they don't belong. And examples are that we are Muslims, they are Hindus, we are Pakistani. And then reference group is there. So people use as a standard in evaluating or understanding themselves, their attitudes. Like see that in-group, then how the people are in group, how the people are reference group, and out of groups, and so on. All about our lectures today. Thank you very much. Stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.